Hello everyone and welcome to the channel. So it is official, Sergino Dest is finally a FC Barcelona player. And so now that it is official and now that Dest is a Barcelona player, we are going to be comparing two players in this video, and that is going to be Nelson Semedo and Sergino Dest. I think that it is only right to compare these two players so we can understand what Sergino Dest could bring compared to Nelson Semedo. And so in this video, I am going to be talking about the attacking output of what Sergino Dest could bring. In the other video, it is going to be about the defensive output. So there is going to be two videos when it comes to comparing Nelson Semedo and Sergino Dest. And so there is a lot to talk about, a lot to analyze. And so we are first going to start with the attacking output of this player. And so here are the big questions right now when it comes to Sergino Dest. What could Dest bring in the final third? And who and why did Barcelona sign this type of player? And so in this video, we are going to be talking about three different traits, and that is the progressive runs. Number two is going to be the crosses, and number three is going to be the shot assist. Starting with the progressive runs, if you guys do not know what the progressive runs are, it's basically when you do retain the ball and then move forward. So you get the ball and then pass it forward, or you get the ball and run forward, or get the ball and cross it to the box. Anything that is progressive. Not being progressive is when you retain the ball and then you do a side pass, or you retain the ball and you back pass, or you retain the ball and you run back. That is not being progressive. And I think that the ultimate example of having a progressive run would be a player like Trent from Liverpool or Alphonso Davies from Bayern Munich. Notice how those two players love to be progressive. They either like to cross the ball or run all the way into the box. And so let's first analyze Nelson Semedo, and these are going to be the stats of the 2019-2020 season with Barcelona. And if we look at this image here, we can see that Nelson Semedo does like to start wide with these progressive runs. Notice how in the red, that basically means that he's not making a progressive run and he's either doing a side pass or passing back. But in the progressive runs that he has completed, which is the light blue ones, you can see that he does like to start wide and then cut in much later. And then as for Sergino Dest, which is the complete opposite, Dest likes to cut in earlier, then move wide as he gets into the final third. And this is telling me two things when it comes to Sergino Dest. One is that they are equal when it comes to the progressive runs in the final third. There is no difference, but they do go in for different reasons. And again, notice how there's so many red dots, which is again a side pass or a back pass. Notice how both of them do have a lot of red dots and non-progressive runs in that final third. I think that it does happen for different reasons. As for Semedo, it's simply because he's just not capable enough to go forward. And as for Sergino Dest, it could sometimes be because he is inexperienced. Sometimes he does not know what to do, which is to either side pass, back pass, or move forward. And analyzing these two images, the second thing that I did get was that Dest is capable to be progressive in his own half, and that is very important, and I'm going to explain why. I believe that this is the reason why Sergino Dest is being brought into FC Barcelona. Notice how Sergino Dest likes to be progressive in his own half because he is able to get out of dangerous areas, which is something that's going to be completely important for FC Barcelona in those important matches. Let me give you a great example on why it's important. If we look at the match between Barcelona and Bayern Munich, there was a moment between Sergio Roberto and Nelson Semedo where they were trying to get out and away from Bayern's press, but they were incapable because they simply did not know how to move forward, and then they lost the ball, and then that created a chance for Bayern Munich to score a goal. Knowing how well he can get away from dangerous areas, Dest is that player that can retain the ball and move forward, and that's going to be extremely important for a club like FC Barcelona. And overall, we can see that Sergino Dest completes a total of 2.37 progressive runs per match, and as for Nelson Semedo, he completes a total of 2.34 progressive runs per match. But the moral of the story is this: where do these right backs complete these progressive runs? And I think that with Sergino Dest providing these type of runs in his own half is going to be extremely important for Barcelona. Now I want to move on to the crosses, and these are going to be the crosses along with the accurate crosses. And I believe that this is a very important trait that every right back should have, because one of the greatest examples examples from this is Liverpool's right back Trent, and we all know what he can do. He provides one of the best crosses in the world, and this is why Liverpool have been so successful in these past two seasons. And when you do have a accurate crosser in your team, that is basically the cure of a deep block. This is something that Barcelona always encounter in every season in almost every team. And with Barcelona having a player like Ansu Fati, who is a strong aerial presence on the pitch and arguably one of the best in the league, I think that having a great right back that knows how to cross is going to bring the best out of our own players. And so let's focus on Nelson Semedo for a second, right? He was doing a total of 1.3 crosses per match, and in total throughout the course of the 2019-2020 season, he has done 42 crosses total, and out of those 42 crosses, 26.2% were accurate. Then moving on to Sergino Dest, he has done a total of 2.96 crosses per match, and throughout the whole season with Ajax, he has done 96 crosses total, with 30.2% of those 96 crosses being accurate. And if we look at the image here, we can have a better idea on where Sergino Dest does like to do his crosses. And to be very honest, I really do like what I'm seeing here. We can see that Sergino Dest is a player that does like to take risk on the right side, and most importantly, really pay attention to where those crosses do land. We can see that his crosses usually land after the penalty spot, which is something that's going to be extremely important, right, in order for you to increase your chances to score those goals. Because usually when we see Semedo or Roberto make those crosses usually end up outside of the box. So in terms of crosses, I believe that Sergino Dest is a great upgrade for FC Barcelona. And that is because of his success rate in those crosses, the amount of crosses he does, and where he places those crosses at. That is going to be a vital part in Barcelona's game in this upcoming season. And that's greatly going to benefit two players like Antoine Griezmann and Ansu Fati especially. Moving on to the shot assist. If you guys don't know what the shot assist is, it's very self-explanatory. You're basically assisting a player in order for him to take a shot. You're putting him in the best position to succeed to take that shot. And this is a trait that is a must-have for every right back, which is why I do want to talk about this in this video. And this is greatly going to be important for a team like Barcelona, because Barcelona have two players who do extremely well when it comes to shooting, and that is Lionel Messi and Felipe Coutinho. And if we look here, Dest has done a total of 21 shot assists throughout the course of the season. As for Nelson Semedo, he has done 15 shot assists throughout the 2019-2020 season. And then we can see here, I'm going to show you guys some images on where Sergino Dest and Nelson Semedo do their shot assist. We can see here that Semedo is much more cautious on where he does start his shot assist, which is something that I actually do prefer, because if you are going to be more cautious, if you are going to start those shot assists within the box, you do have a higher chance of having that shot assist being completed. And then as for Sergino Dest, just like in the crosses and in those progressive runs, Dest is a player that's much wider, who does like to provide those shot assists in a wider area. And I believe that that is also going to be very beneficial, right? Because if you do provide those shot assists in those areas, you do end up stretching the opposition's defense. And if you do end up stretching the opposition's defense, you do give more space to players like Coutinho, Ansu Fati, Lionel Messi, and many other players. And obviously, if you do provide those shot assist closer into the box, you are going to end up more cramped, and in result, it's going to be harder for you to try and find and set up these players. So there are pros and cons to the way Nelson Semedo does it and the way that Sergino Dest provides those shot assists. And so here's the final conclusion when it comes to the attacking output, now seeing all of these statistics. I believe that Barcelona signed Sergino Dest because he is a player that is not afraid to do the high risk, high reward. Dest is also a player that plays much wider in his game, which I believe is going to suit him the best and Barcelona. And that is going to allow Barcelona to extremely benefit and see different plays within their game. And if you really examine how well Sergino Dest does come out from the dangerous areas, which is in his own half, and then you examine how well he does around the box when it comes to the crosses, the progressive runs, the area that really does need to be addressed, and we can see here in the image, is that Dest needs to be more effective in the middle. We can see that in the green areas, that is where he is the most effective, but in the red, that is where Sergino Dest does find himself to be the most inefficient. And I believe that Barcelona is going to want to count on Sergino Dest to transition into the attack, and that's going to be extremely important. Can Sergino Dest improve in that red area? He could. Sergino Dest is a very young player. He is raw talent. And I believe that in time, throughout the course of this season, he will be able to participate even more and be involved more in the middle of the pitch, which I believe is going to be Barcelona's most important part in order for them to transition easily into the attack. And so overall, I really do believe that Sergino Dest is an improvement to Nelson Semedo. And again, seeing these stats here, we can see that Sergino Dest is a right back that does need to be developed. And I believe that he will. And in time, he could become, if done right, one of the best right backs in the world. And at 19 years old, he really does have a whole career ahead of him. But let me know what you guys think, right? Do you believe that Sergino Dest, seeing these stats, is a massive upgrade to Nelson Semedo? And do you see Sergino Dest developing his game throughout the course of his first season with FC Barcelona? And this is going to conclude part one of two of comparing Sergino Dest and Nelson Semedo. So if you guys are watching this, you are watching the first half. The second half is going to be right after this video. So make sure to stay tuned. Again, I am extremely excited to see Sergino Dest become a Barcelona player in this upcoming season. I'm excited to see what he does have to provide when it comes to the attacking output. And so whatever does happen, whatever he does improve on, whatever he does show, we are going to be talking about it here in this YouTube channel. I am going to be saving these graphs, so like in about 9 to 10 months we can see and make these graphs again and see just how much he has improved his game. So that'll be it for today's Barcelona player analysis video. I want to thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next video.